Hi, this is JP from Not the Lights Over Arkham. This time in Unexpected Courage series, I will be playing the Circle Undone box with in addition to the usual two core set player cards, and I will be playing Marie Lambeau that comes in the Circle Undone deluxe box. So the Circle Undone is quite tough for true solo, but it is doable with the right kind of deck. You might not be fortunate enough to win the campaign in your blind playthrough, because I think the Circle Undone is the first campaign that really makes you metagame to build a deck that really tackles the troublesome parts of the campaign, and one of those is the haunted keyword, which is really nasty, so you really should be sure to succeed in your investigations to avoid all of the nasty haunted effects. But let's see how Marie does with her deck in the Witching Hour, which is the first scenario that you play with your investigator deck. So I am not playing the prelude scenario with the neutral party guests. So we are starting from the Witching Hour scenario, and I will be playing as I have rejected my fate. So we have two Elder Thing tokens in the Chaos pack, and we don't add any tarot cards in the campaign setup into Marie's deck. So speaking of Marie's deck, let's look what we have in her deck. I started with the usual flashlights. They are really useful with Marie, as Marie has a high intellect, so even a tough location with the flashlight is doable without using any boost cards. I also have two magnifying glasses, because Marie is able to take 5 splash cards from either Seeker or Survivor, so I took 2 magnifying glasses to boost the intellect for investigating a bit more. It's really good to be 3 up in this campaign, as the Elder Things are minus 3s in this scenario, for example. Then we have one copy of Scrying. This is just because I was one card short from having a full deck, so I decided to add the Scrying. It could be really useful to avoid getting a bad treachery in a clutch situation, so you can a bit mitigate the treacheries you are pulling from the encounter deck. So for example, if you're in a tight spot and you don't want to see an enemy, you can arrange the top 3 cards of the encounter deck so that you don't get an enemy. Of course, if you get an enemy, there are 2 shrivelings just in case. I am not counting on these shrivelings, but if I get one to the table, I can be confident that I usually will hit with Marie using the shriveling. And there is 1 Holy Rosary to boost the willpower. And of course, because Marie is dabbling into the mysticism or doom, so to speak, there are 2 copies of Arcane Initiate to search for those cards and activate Marie's ability to have an extra action if a card she controls has a doom on it. And I also added the Arcane Studies, because it boosts both willpower and intellect, which is useful for Marie in this build. Then maybe the weirdest card to see here is 2 copies of Track Shoes. Track Shoes is a really powerful card. It boosts Marie's agility to 4, and also lets Marie avoid enemies better. You can just pass by enemies with track shoes to not take any engage actions from them and just keep on going. And it's really useful in the later part of this campaign, but also a bit useful in this scenario. Then we have one of the staple cards that came out of this deluxe box, which is for mystics the deny existence. It's a really strong card to ignore losing cards for a random effect or taking damage or horror. So it's a really good card and also has a wild icon for clutch situations. Then of course we want to avoid from now and then to failing an investigation check in a haunted location. So Drawn to the Flame is really useful. So you don't have to test, you just get the clues and get an encounter card. Then the usual two emergency caches, a Ward of Protections. I decided to take my last splash card from Seeker, and it's Deduction. This is because the last location of this scenario needs you to either defeat an elite enemy or get all of the clues out of the location, and Deduction lets us get one extra clue, which will hopefully be enough so that we can grab all the clues without getting to hit too many times. But then we have the usual basic or neutral events, or not events but skills. We have two guts, two manual dexterities, two perception and two unexpected courage. And for this playthrough, the random basic weakness ended up being the 13th vision, which is quite annoying. And if I see it, I probably will try to get rid of it, because many times the getting equal to the skill check is really what we are looking for. And now we, if we have the 13th vision in play, we really need to boost more to skill tests to not fail. But that is the deck we are using. We have taken into note the errata for the witching hour. So in the setup in the booklet, it says place 4 of the witch haunted woods locations into play. This might result you having too few locations with clues to finish the scenario. So because we are getting the Arkham Woods location later in the game, it might result that you don't get a location that gives you a clue, and if these don't have enough clues, then you are unable to finish the scenario. So the errata fixes this, and now we have 5 Arkham Witch Haunted Woods locations in play in the setup, so we definitely have enough clues on the map to get enough to get to the end of the scenario. Other than that, we are of course playing the regular version, because the Return to version is not yet out. It's scheduled to be out later this summer, and I'm really looking forward to it. But for now, we are stuck with the regular version. So I think that's enough of the deck and scenario. So let's get started. We have pre-shuffled the deck, so let's draw our opening hand. So we get manual dexterity, Drawn to the Flame, guts, deny existence, and Ward of Protection. I think this location makes you, let's see, so these have some nasty force abilities, so it has 4 shroud, 2 clues. After any number of clues are discovered from this location, each investigator at this location must discard an equal number of cards at random from his or her hand. So, let's see. So, for example, deny existence doesn't work for this location because it's not an encounter card or an enemy. So, we still probably want to grab the clues with the drawn to the flame. And I think all of the... we could keep the ward of protection. No. We'll draw 4 cards so we get the Holy Rosary, Flashlight, Guts, and Mystifying Song. Okay, so I think the plan is to play down the assets and just Drawn to the Flame and lose those 2 cards. And that's okay by me. We get some setup and we get 2 clues and an encounter card. So, well, the encounter card could be really bad, but then it is worth well taking that risk. So, first action, we'll play down the Flashlight. Second action, we'll play down the Holy Rosary. So, pretty fast turn. And last action, we will draw into the flame. And we will draw an encounter card. This Rotting Remains. So at this point, we resolve the encounter card from the encounter deck. So I will commit Guts, and I'll just commit the Mystifying Song to this test. So we are testing 8 versus 4. We are losing those cards, so just why not? We succeed. We take no horror. We draw a card from, and we get the deny existence. So then we get these 2 clues, and we lose the deny existence, unfortunately. But that is our turn. We got 2 clues. We got 2 assets in play, so a pretty decent first turn. No enemies, we'll go to upkeep. We draw a card, Ward of Protection, really nice. And we gain 1 resource. So that is the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a Doom. The Doom threshold is 8, so 1 of 8 Doom. Encounter card for this turn is Dissonant Voices. We can't play assets or events. Well, lucky we already have our assets in play and we don't need to play an event. So, first action, let's move to a connecting location. And these all are connected, so I can move freely to any location, but they are random, so I'll just go here. So, we find the Witch-Hunted Woods. Overgrown Barn. It's a 3 shroud location with 1 clue. When an enemy would spawn at a different Witch Hunt would spawn it at this location instead, then it makes an immediate attack against each investigator at this location. Okay. Oh, and I forgot to talk about that. We need 2 clues to advance. I already have it, but a good tactic for this scenario is to gather 6 clues per investigator before you start advancing. After that, you can basically advance in 1 turn and get more easily to the end of the scenario. So we are doing that tactic. And also, locations in front of you are connected to one another. You cannot enter location in front of other investigators. Well, we are playing through solo, so there are no other investigators. So they are all just connected. and we can spend clues at the end of the round to advance as a group, but we are waiting until we have enough clues. So I'll use the flashlight here to investigate for my second action. So investigating 4 versus 1. So I'm 3 up. It's a skull. Skull is -1 for each point you fail by discarding the card of the encounter deck. So it's -1. We still succeed. We'll grab this clue. Last action, we want to move out of this location, so we'll just move here. And we find the Witch Hunted Woods abandoned mine. So it's a 2-shroud location with 1 clue. You cannot investigate this location while you have between 1 and 3 and 10 resources. Action, choose an investigator, different Witch Hunted Woods. Move up to one of your resources to that investigator's resource pool, or vice versa, group lead once per run. So that is not an option in true solo, but I have a way to lose one resource. Next round, we will just hopefully ward of protection, so we can get rid of the next encounter card. So that is my turn. No enemies, we go to upkeep. We draw unexpected courage and we get the resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom. Encounter card for this turn is another dissonant voices. But as I said, we need to get rid of one resource. So I will ward of protection this dissonant voices, even if it's a bit of a waste. But we need to get rid of one resource so we can investigate this location. And we take one horror, and I'll put it on the rosary. First action, we will use the flashlight to investigate. So investigating 4-0. Actually, let's. This is not a haunted location, so I'm just investigating without committing anything or using the flashlight. I really want to save the flashlight to a location that is harder for us to investigate. So I am 2 up, hopefully that is enough. Well, autofail is always an autofail, so nothing. Good thing we didn't use the flashlight. So trying again. Up by 2. That is not enough, so we'll try again. And really hoping I succeed on this try. So it's a -1, so we lost our whole turn. That's not good, but at least we saved a bit of our resources and we are doing quite well. So we only have 2 doom in play and we already have the 4 clues of 6 we need in total. So no enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we find the arcane initiate and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 3 of 8 doom, and counter card for this turn is Diabolic Voices. Test will power 3. For each point you fail by, discard 1 random card from your hand. For each card you cannot discard, take 1 horror or 1 damage. This test gets +1 difficulty for each copy of Diabolic Voices in the encounter discard pile. So it's only a willpower 3 test. So I'm just testing it. I'm up by 2, so I'm testing 5 versus 3. So it's a +1. So we succeed, and that is that. I think the first action we do is to play the Arcane Initiate down. So we actually get an extra action to use for spells. I'll just mark it like so. And we'll look for spells. So I'm exhausting the initiate. Okay, so we don't find a spell, but we also get our signature weakness shuffled, hopefully, towards the bottom of the deck. so that guy doesn't come to bother us too soon, hopefully. Then next action we'll move to next location, and it is the Witch Haunted Woods, the Lonely Tree. You cannot investigate this location while you have between 3 to 5 cards in hand. Well, that is good. And 2 short, 1 clue. Last action, I'll actually use the flashlight so we get the clue faster. So I'm investigating 4 versus 0, so only the auto fail will fail us. It's a -4, so we get this clue that was here. So we have 5 of the 6 clues we need. And no enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, a ward of protection, and we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 5 Doom of 8, and counter card for this turn is Coven Initiate. Nothing we can do about that. So, Revelation, discard the top 2 cards of the encounter deck. If this effect causes the encounter deck to run out, draw the topmost hex card in the encounter discard pile. So, we really don't want to see any of these witches, but it is what it is. We have no way of killing this witch at this moment. So, I'll use the Arcane Initiate first to search for a spell. And no spells. Hopefully, I think we are evading this and moving on. And there's no point in trying to punch with our one measly strength or combat. Okay. So, this is engaged with us. First action, we will evade, and I'm committing the unexpected courage to this test, so I'm evading 5 versus 2. It's a -2, so that's good enough. This witch is evaded. Next action, we'll move to the last location, and it is the Witch Haunted Woods Cairn Stones. So, 3 shroud, 2 clues. Forced after any number of clues are discovered from this location, each investigator at this location loses an equal number of resources. Okay. So, I think we are using the flashlight. So, I'm investigating 4 versus 1. So 3 up. -3. That's enough. We get 1 clue and we lose 1 resource. And now we actually have enough resources, but enough clues. So we have 6 clues. But I think last action. I think we will draw a card. Yeah, so let's draw a card. We find the magnifying glass, and I'll actually play that because it's a fast action. So, that is that. No enemy actions, we go to upkeep. That readies, and we gain a card, we find the emergency cash, and we get 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. We are at 6 of 8 doom. Encounter card for this turn is Priestess of the Coven. Well, that is unlucky. We really don't want to see any of this. So it's a 2, 5, 3, health 2, evade, humanoid witch, retaliate, Priestess of the Coven gets plus one fight and plus one evade for each witch enemy in the encounter discard pile. Well, luckily it's zero. Well, actually, let's back up. I totally forgot this. So this was discarded and this was discarded. So this is actually the card we are drawing. Okay, so back up. And test willpower 5. For each point you fail by discard the card of the encounter deck, if it's a curse, treachery, discard by... okay, so I'm just gonna ward this. Okay, sorry about that, because I was thinking out loud, I forgot to do the revelation effect last turn, so we'll just correct that now. So that is done, we go to the investigation phase. I think we are still trying to find some good cards to be able to handle the next couple of acts. So I am using the initiate to search for a spell. Finally, we find the shriveling. That is really good. Now we have an option to defeat Annette Mason at the end with the shriveling, because we have a pretty good willpower. Because we're not seeing our blue acceleration check for some reason. Okay, well, first action will play the emergency cash, second action will play the shriveling. And because we don't have anything better to do, last action we'll just investigate. Investigating 5 versus 3. That is actually a victory point location, so we would be playing a campaign. So it would be in our benefit to get this last clue. And unfortunately it's an auto fail, so we don't get the clue from here. At the end of the round, yeah, so upkeep, that enemy doesn't do anything upkeep, we draw a card, manual dexterity and gain one resource. Then we spend the two clues needed here. So at the end of the round, let's do this. Deeper into the woods. Each investigator must randomly choose one of the setups at Arkham Woods locations. Put it into play in front of him or her, and immediately move to that location. Cannot be cancelled. Each investigator spawns a set aside code spawn at his or her location, and each investigator tests will or agility 3. Each investigator who succeeds exhausts that enemy and disengages from it. Shuffle one of the set aside copies of Demonic Piping into the encounter deck. Place the other two in the discard pile. Okay, so. Pretty big setup. So we have the Arcane Woods locations here. So we grab one at random. So this one. So we move to it. And it is the Arkham Woods Twisting Paths. It is a three shard location with one clue. When you move out of this location, just Intellect 3. If you fail, cancel the effects of the move. Okay, so that is quite annoying. Might cost us a lot of actions if we are unlucky. So there is one clue here, which we don't need. Next, we shuffle one of these and place two of these here. We get one gold spawn. So let's do this first. And at the end, because we're at the end of the round, this won't ready anymore. So we are actually, we could save this and we'll just test 5 versus 3 with our willpower. It's a -2. It is good enough. So this comes into play exhausted. So we have a 1 turn to run away from it. But before that, we'll advance this also. So we spend 1 more clue. And strength melodies for the remainder of the scenario. Investigators may move, may now enter a location in front of other investigators. And then we need to spend 3 clues, but I'll do that next turn. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 7 Doom of 8. Encounter card for this turn is Frozen in Fear. Well, this is not really nice. Okay, well, nothing we can do about that. We are trying to move out of this location for our first action. So it takes up 2 actions. And we are testing 4 versus 3. It's a +1, so luckily we are able to move out. Now, we'll spend these clues to advance. So, we get the Witch's Circle. Revelation, put the Witch's Circle into play in the center of the play area in front of none of the investigators. The lead investigator spawns the set-aside Annette Mason at the Witch's Circle. Paused. After the enemy's phase begins, move each ready unengaged witch enemy at once towards the Witch's Circle. Okay. So, Witch's Circle comes here. There are 3 clues here. And Annette Mason is there also. And Annette Mason has 4 fight, 4 health per investigator, so 4 and 4 evade. Humanoid Witch Elite retaliate, forced. After the enemy phase begins, discard the top 3 cards of the encounter deck. Spawn each witch enemy discarded by this effect at Annette Mason's location. If no witch enemies are discarded by this effect, ready her. Okay, so just put it over here. Okay, so we still have 1 action left. So we really don't want to move in this turn. I'll check the top 3 cards with the acolytes. I'll grab the arcane studies. Oh no, I can't. I'll have to grab the other shriveling. Because arcane studies is not a spell. So I think we can move in because we want to have certainty of 2 actions to defeat Annette next turn, and we can actually kill off the arcane initiate. Okay. So last action we'll just move in. So Annette engages us. That is our turn. We'll test this. So I'm testing 5 versus 3. It's a 0. So we get rid of the frozen in fear. Okay, I'm just checking. So we have 2 objectives. If Annette Mason is defeated, advance, or if there are no clues on the Witch's Circle, advance. At this point, it looks like our better bet is to defeat Annette Mason. So, after the enemy phase begins move each ready and engage which enemy runs towards the witch's circle. So this moves here, engages us, and they both hit me, so I'll take one horror on myself. This is from the Coven Initiate, and Animation defeats the Arcane Initiate. So at least we get rid of one Doom to slow things down. Then okay, so let's discard the top three cards. This I forgot to do. So we don't hit any witches. So after the enemy phase begins, discard the top three cards and round the card to spawn each witch enemy discarded by this man. Okay. Then yeah, that is that turn. Enemies attacked will ready cards. This readies. And upkeep we get a card and gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Okay, so this is possibly the last turn of the game if we manage to defeat Animation. Let's see what the encounter deck has to offer. So we are again at 7 doom of 8 because we got rid of the Arcane Initiate. We also actually lose this extra action for spells, which I forgot to use last turn. Well, it is what it is. Encounter card is Centuries of Secrets. Test willpower 5. For each point you fail by, discard the top card of the encounter deck. If it's a curse, treachery is discarded. By this way, deal 1 indirect damage to your investigator and each of your allies. Well, I am not committing anything to this test, so I'm testing 5 versus 5. It is a minus 3, and it's an elder thing. So we ready exhausted witch enemy and heal damage from it. Well, luckily there are no damage to heal and they are already ready. So still we fail by 3, so we discard 3 cards. So terror, curse, hex. So we take 1 damage. Okay, now we need to defeat Animation. So first action, we will shrivel. I am up by 1. It is plus 1, so 2 damage. Second action, we will shrivel. And it is an elder sign. And we just... well, we won't add a doom anywhere, but we will defeat an Animation. And that is enough for us to advance. So, if you advance by defeating an Animation, stop, the Coven Leader yells in a commanding voice, grimacing from the wounds you've inflicted. You're not sure if she is speaking to you or to the hooded women surrounding you, but regardless, there is a sudden stillness in the clearing around the circle. Resolution 1. Okay. So, that went pretty smoothly. As you can see, the tactic of advancing multiple acts at the same time is really strong. You basically don't want to advance to this act to get the goat spawn and then have to search for clues and deal with the goat spawn. You rather want to advance, deal with the goat spawn, advance, and get to the end and have a good plan of what you are doing at the end. Either defeat an Animation or, for example, exhaust, or take the damage from her and get the clues off of the location. But this went pretty well, and as you can see, Marie is pretty good at investigating with the 4 intellect, and also if you add some spell cards that require willpower, she is pretty good at doing that also, and also evading when you get the track shoes done. Well, we didn't get it that this game, but that was Unexpected Courage, the Circle Undone with Marie Lambeau. Hope you guys liked this playthrough. Thanks for watching. And as always, until next time.